Namaste, good afternoon, good evening. How are you?
Fine, sir.
Good morning.
Nice, so nice to see you.
And you too.
All over the world.
Yes, that's right.
Indian nurses.
Yes, Rahulji.
Helping everybody.
Yes.
So you make us very proud, especially in this time.
Thank you, sir.
We don't often get to say this to you publicly, but you are representatives of our country, and you are doing us proud. Not just you,
thank you, millions of men,
brothers and sisters like you. So it's an honor for me to speak to you, actually.
You'll be wondering why
I thought I should have a chat with you. And there are a couple of reasons. One is, there are some of you who are abroad, some of you who are working in India. All of you have a different experience. So I wanted to have a conversation so that we could get a sense of what different people are seeing in different parts of the world, and how they can help each other, or how you can advise some of our people, how our people can advise you abroad. So that's one aspect. Second aspect is, I wanted to get a sense that you should feel, not just you, but as a community, you should feel that we are with you. We understand you're doing a dangerous job. We understand this is not an easy job. We understand you're putting your lives on the line for this. And we appreciate greatly what you're doing all over the world and in India. So I'd like to start by asking you to introduce yourselves.
My name is Shirley.
Yeah.
I work in Liverpool, England. I've been here for more than 21 years.
This is Vipin Krishnan. I'm Vipin Krishnan. Kerala se hu basically. 9 saal se Delhi AIMS mein kaam karta hu.
Acha. Vipin ji, aapko corona ho gaya?
Rahul ji, unfortunately.
you are both fighting the disease personally and also on behalf of AIMS.
Yeah, both me and my wife are infected. We are right now in quarantine.
But I believe you're okay now.
Yes, I am perfectly okay, Rahul ji. I'm perfectly okay. Thank you, Rahul ji.
That is good news.
I'm Narendra Singh. I'm from Rajasthan. I belong to the Sikar district. I've been working in nursing for 15 years. I did work in Jaipur. I did work in Ramano Loya Hospital. And the last job I did work in the Safdarjung before I left the country. Now I'm working in Australia, New South Wales Health, Liverpool Hospital Intensive Care, and been working there 4 years, and looking after this old COVID patient. And now I think we learned a lot from last couple of months.
My name is Anu Ragnat. I'm from New Zealand. So I came here in 2004. So I work in, as a clinical nurse specialist for older people in the community. So in Northland District Health Board and Whangarei. Thank you so much for taking this time to talk to us Indian nurses. And you're really showing the compassion. So thank you so much.
So this must be easily the most difficult time that you have faced. I don't think any of you would have seen anything of this scale. Can you give me a sense of how you are feeling while you are sort of in the front line?
When this COVID started, we initially thought this is a simple flu. Mm-hmm. And we thought the flu is killing more people than COVID. So we didn't took really seriously this one. Once the COVID start rolling over, and then we see the news every day, and then Italy and the mortality rate is going higher and higher, then that time we start thinking more, and we thought this is not a flu. This is really serious. I think we have to take very serious this one. And then we start preparing on that one, and then all the equipment, setting up the ICU, different ICU that's especially dedicated for only for COVID patients.
Australia and New Zealand have done pretty well.
Yeah, it's really well. I think they did really well. I totally agree with you. Yeah.
The cities like Auckland, Christchurch, Hamilton, they are pretty crowded. So it could have driven easily into five figures if New Zealanders were careless. So I think going hard and going early was the motto by the Prime Minister Jacinda. So she's done absolutely well. I think going hard and early was really the right thing, and that really flattened the curve in New Zealand.
You mentioned that there was fear, and obviously something like this will create fear among the patients, among those who think they're going to get sick, among the nurses, among the doctors. Can you give me a sense of what this fear was like in the hospitals? What did you feel? Were you worried that something might happen? What was the sense?
For me, I work in acute medical unit, so we receive patients directly from the community. So initially there was a lot of fear. So who is going to catch this virus? Is the patients all coming with this virus? So my personal experience was when I was seeing a patient, she came in with, no COVID symptoms. She only came in with the diarrhea and vomiting. But because of her abdominal pain, I requested an abdominal X-ray and a chest X-ray. And her chest X-ray was reported within minutes. And it came back as, typical severe COVID chest X-ray. So that made us all really, I wouldn't say paranoid, but, it was very, very cautious. So I did speak to my clinical directors, my clinical lead at the time. And at that time, that was the beginning of March. Even at the time in UK, the case, we were not even in the lockdown. So we've been told, so we have to use the PPE, surgical mask, usual apron and gloves. So, and since then, I've been using that, and we were seeing patients at the time, day after day, and then we went into lockdown.
What is your experience in AIIMS? How are you feeling in AIIMS? Because you are their sort of epidemic is winding down, or our epidemic is picking up.
राहुल जी, हमारा देश की हालत मेरे से ज्यादा आपको पता है.
आप सब हिंदी समझते हैं?
राहुल जी, उसके पहले मैं थोड़ा स्टैटिस्टिक्स पे आना चाहता हूँ. हमारा देश की स्टैटिस्टिक्स यही है, वी हैव 1.2 मिलियन रजिस्टर्ड एलोपैथिक डॉक्टर्स इन इंडिया एंड वी हैव अराउंड 3.7 मिलियन रजिस्टर्ड नर्सेस इन इंडिया. When we are coming to the ratio, it is 1 is to 1,500 for doctors and 1 is to 1.7 is to 1,000 nurses in India. But the WHO recommended is 1 is to 1,000 doctors and 3 is to 1,000 doctors when coming to the recommendations of WHO. So we are running short in the scenario of human resources. But yeah, still, we are fighting hard. But in our country, the scenario is entirely different. If we talk about private hospitals, ki baat karega, और गवर्नमेंट हॉस्पिटल्स की बात करेगा, वो दोनों बिल्कुल आसमान जमीन की अंदर हम उसके उसमें दिखेंगे हमें.
क्या फर्क लगता है आपको?
सो व्हेन वी आर लुकिंग इनटू द प्राइवेट सेक्टर, देयर आर लॉट ऑफ डिस्क्रिमिनेशंस. प्राइवेट नर्सेस यही कह रहे राहुल जी, उनकी सैलरीज कट हो रहे इस पैंडेमिक की सिचुएशन पे. अगर उनकी फैमिलीज को वो कैसे देखभाल करेगा अगर उनकी इस सिचुएशन में? मुझे लग रहा है सरकार उनको मदद करना चाहिए और सारे प्राइवेट हॉस्पिटल्स उनकी पूरा सैलरीज देना चाहिए. इस कंडीशन में वो कैसे उनको मतलब जीना ही मुश्किल करेंगे, हो जाएगा. हाउ कैन दे लुक आफ्टर देयर फैमिलीज एट दिस पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम? इट विल बी वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर देम टू सर्वाइव इवन. बिकॉज आपने एक चीज पूछा था, आपको डर लग रहा था. इन्हें क्यों नहीं, हमें कोई एक, मुझे नहीं लग अगर कोरोना महामारी, क्योंकि इस देश को बचाने के लिए आगे था, फ्रंटलाइन में ही तो था. क्योंकि मैं मेरा खुद एक्सपीरियंस कह रहा है, मैं मुझे कोई डर नहीं था. अब मैं कोरोना हो गया तो भी मुझे डर नहीं लग रहा है. मैं सरकार से और आपसे ही कहना चाहता हूँ, मैं ठीक होके मुझे पहले कोविड वार्ड में ही जाना चाहता हूँ मैं.
हाँ बिल्कुल. मगर मुझे एक चीज की बड़ा आश्चर्य हुआ. हाँ, काफी अस्पतालों में दिल्ली में मुझे बताया जा रहा है कि टेस्टिंग ही अलाउ नहीं हो रही है.
हाँ जी राहुल जी, ये बहुत दुख की बात और दर्दनाक वाली बात है. क्योंकि मैं आपको एक उसके बारे में एक स्टैटिस्टिक्स बताना चाहता हूँ. क्योंकि 27 मई को हमारे दिल्ली का इन्फेक्शन रेट था 13.7%. उस टाइम पे हम 7,000 टेस्टिंग कर रहे थे एवरेज पर डे. अब हम जून 12-13 पे आ गया तो हमारी इन्फेक्शन रेट 30% के अबव बढ़ गया है. और हमने हमारी टेस्टिंग 5,000 की नीचे लेके आ रहे. ये बहुत आश्चर्य की बात है. क्योंकि इन्फेक्शन रेट एक तरफ से बढ़ रहा है और डेथ्स भी बढ़ रहे हैं और हम अपना टेस्टिंग कम कर रहे हैं. मुझे समझ में नहीं आ रहा राहुल जी, व्हाट इज हैपनिंग.
हाँ, बिकॉज समवन वाज टेलिंग मी, वन ऑफ द डॉक्टर्स आई वाज स्पीकिंग टू इन वन ऑफ द प्राइवेट हॉस्पिटल वाज टेलिंग मी दैट इट बिकम्स इम्पॉसिबल फॉर देम टू वर्क इफ दे कैन नॉट टेस्ट कोविड पेशेंट्स.
एब्सोल्युटली राहुल जी,
पेशेंट दे डोंट नो वेदर ही हैज कोविड और नॉट, वेयर टू पुट हिम. Putting two patients, one who has COVID, one who doesn't have COVID, next to each other. So they were saying that they are completely frustrated and they do not know how to move forward. I think little bit is the governments are trying to manage the perception. They're trying to make give a sense that the problem is not as bad as it is, as bad as it is. But I believe that, look, we have to face the problem. So we should accept the problem, define the problem accurately, and then fight the problem. I don't know how you react to that.
No, राहुल जी आपने बिल्कुल सही बोला है. देखो हमारे पास एक पैंडेमिक सिचुएशन है और एम्स की डायरेक्टर ने भी यही बोला है, वी आर गोइंग टू द पीक एट जून जुलाई हाफ. सो इवन द दिल्ली चीफ मिनिस्टर रेस्पेक्टेड अरविंद केजरीवाल जी हैज टोल्ड दैट दे आर एक्सपेक्टिंग 5.5 लाख केसेस. वी आर हैविंग अराउंड 10,000 बेड्स इन दिल्ली एंड कैन यू इमेजिन द डेप्थ ऑफ द थिंग दैट इफ 5.5 लाख पीपल आर कमिंग, डेफिनेटली विल नॉट कम एट अ टाइम. But average 1 lakh patients a day, I can't imagine the depth of the situation. What will we do?
Yeah.
It's quite
strange. How do some of the people from abroad react to this?
I just want to ask Vipin. Vipin, so you're on sick leave at the moment. Is that being paid or are they paying you?
Right now, institution has told that it's paid, but there's not, since there are a lot of people, it's a pandemic, a lot of people are getting infected, healthcare workers. I'm even worried about that. So right now they're telling it's paid, but I don't know what will happen in the future time.
And how easy it was for you to get the testing done though? It was okay for you? Was it quite accessible?
Yes, but when my wife's turn came, my turn was little okay, but when my wife's turn came, she had to wait for a complete 10 hours. It was little worrying, and it was a sad kind of incident for me.
Yeah, that's quite upsetting. As a family.
I want to add in one of the points you said that very hard to do testing. Yeah. So as Rahul ji mentioned that you go to private hospital and they can't test it. If you go to private hospital and then you can't test it, it's very hard to manage because you can spread very easy to the other staff as well. And then you became whole hospital staff can get infected. And then, so the testing is very important as much as you do your, you know, social, you know, distancing and the other measure you use for to prevent the COVID-19.
So looking back for the people who are abroad, what is your biggest learning from this epidemic? What would be your advice to Indian hospitals, Indian nurses, Indian doctors, now that you've been through it? What would you say are the key things that one has to look at?
So wash the hand. Wash the hand. You have to wash the hand. During the day, like I do 12-hour shift, during the day, in 12 hours, we do 100 times.
Oh.
Wash the hand. Wash the hand, put a proper PPE. That's quite concerned because I was talking to one of my friend, he works in Delhi, we used to work together. He's saying to me that a lot of staff and doctors are getting positive now, which is one of them, Vipin as well. So, ye badi chinta ki baat hai. If it's getting, it means there's something is missing in that. Either we are not putting properly PPE, either we are not using hand hygiene properly, or we not self-isolating, or maybe we are an asymptomatic carrier there.
So you also have children.
Yes.
The children must be very worried that you are going into the middle of the hospital where everybody has COVID.
So yeah, that's very good question. Very, very good question.
Right, so how are you dealing with that? Can I ask somebody else to come in?
My personal experience is my husband is actually in a high-risk category and he was in shielding. So because I've been working with the COVID patients, so I had to move out of my home, leaving my husband and my children for 6 weeks. Now I've gone back. 2 weeks ago, I went back home. It's because the numbers are coming down. The number of patients in the hospital has come down now. And my management is so supportive for me. here in UK, it is so respectful. People are so respectful. We have dedicated shopping time for the NHS staff or the care workers, whoever is the key workers. We have all those kind of, and every Thursday, the government is, you know, putting it as a clapping for carers and things like that. So, which is so, so supportive. All supermarkets are very supportive.
You feel that you are being backed up by the government fully?
Yes.
Do you feel that in AIIMS at all? Or do you feel that you are alone?
राहुल जी, मैं एक चीज आपका ध्यान में लेके आना चाहता हूँ. एक बहुत इम्पोर्टेंट चीज है और दुख की बात है. राहुल जी, हमारे लिए दो नर्सेस की डेथ हो चुकी है दिल्ली में. देयर वर फ्रॉम साउथ इंडिया. एक एक्सरे टेक्नीशियन, नहीं, एम्स में तो हमारा एक रिटायर्ड डॉक्टर का डेथ हो चुके थे. एंड वी हैड वन सर्विंग पर्सन इन द सैनिटेशन डिपार्टमेंट. वी लॉस्ट हिम अनफॉर्चुनेटली. टिल नाउ, अभी आज के दिन तक उनका जो कॉम्पेंसेशन जो दिल्ली सरकार ने बोला है 1 करोड़ रुपए, अभी तक उनको मिला नहीं. इट्स नॉट दैट वी कैन गिव सम अमाउंट ऑफ मनी एंड सेटल इक्वलाइज द डेथ. इट्स नॉट दैट, बट एटलीस्ट वी शुड सपोर्ट देयर फैमिलीज. सरकार कुछ करना चाहिए इनके बारे में. उनकी जो अमाउंट कॉम्पेंसेशन बोला था, मैं आपके ध्यान में ये डालना चाहता हूँ, क्योंकि आप इस देश की हम ऐसे ही मानते हैं, आप पक्ष की नेता है और
ऑपोजिशन लीडर. आई विल राइट अ लेटर एंड ट्राई एंड सी इफ वी कैन एक्सपेडाइट दैट.
यस, डेफिनेटली राहुल जी. एंड एक दूसरी बात यही है, नर्सेस डजंट कम्स अंडर द रिस्क एलिमेंट्स कैटेगरी ऑफ गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया. द नर्सेस एंड डॉक्टर्स दोनों. So, as healthcare workers, as we are fighting this COVID in the front line, like the army, we can compare this like a biowar, because it's not a biowar, but a virus, a small microscopic organism, is challenging the whole world.
Yeah.
And our country. So we are fighting like the army or the air force. I'm not comparing this with our force, but at least I think you will agree with that. We are fighting as an army.
Yes, you're a non-violent army.
Thank you, Rahul ji. And I would like to bring into your kind consideration that risk allowance should be given to nurses and doctors at least at this point of time, because we are losing lives. We are exhausted and we are fighting in the front line without any fear. हम कोई डर की बात नहीं. हम आगे हम जीत जाएंगे और आप और सरकार सब लोग हमारे साथ हैं. हमारे पूरे विश्वास हैं इस कोरोना के खिलाफ हम ये जंग लड़ेंगे और जीतेंगे.
तो मैंने सवाल पूछा था जो आपके परिवार हैं.
हाँ.
और सबसे पूछ रहा हूँ, जो आपका परिवार है, जो आपके बच्चे हैं.
हाँ.
उनको क्या लग रहा है? उनको मतलब आप कैसे मतलब उनको उनकी देखभाल कर रहे हैं? क्योंकि उनको डर तो लग रहा होगा कि मामा पापा अस्पताल में इतनी बड़ी बीमारी है, क्या होगा?
From the New Zealand government, the first thing the health minister was announced was a 10 million package for health workers. So that includes accommodation funding, Shirley's case, like if you don't want to go back home to an immunocompromised family member, you can stay either in hospital or in nearby motels, and the government would pay for that. Listening to the rest of the team, I feel like we are in a blessed position actually.
Tell me one thing. Why is it that Indian nurses are valued so much abroad? What is it that wherever I go, I went to the Middle East, and they took me to a hospital there, and then in the hospital they said, look, if we didn't have Indian nurses, we could not run our hospital.
That's right.
I have
to
say about that, Indian nurses are very, very hardworking. They dedicate their life to the profession. The Indian nurses don't care about themselves. They see their patients in front of them as either their parent, their children, their mother, their brother or sister. So that's what probably
I think a lot of COVID wards, like we've got people, Indian nurses, in managerial roles and planning, not just on the floor, and definitely in the floor and in the community. There's a lot of Indian nurses, and I think it's we are go-getters. I think you in the front line, you don't think twice. You know, and the education is our the way our course, our curriculum is being designed. I think we are ready to cope in any country, in any situation, in any scenario. Our background, that education, that concrete education curriculum is really backing us, I think. And it's easier for Indian nurses to cope in any situation. We easily adapt. I've been in few other roles before this, and what I felt is like, yeah, you were in there for 2 months, and yeah, you kind of learn just quite quickly. It's just all because of your background, concrete education. And again, as Shirley said, we're quite compassionate by nature.
And how can we help Indian nurses and doctors who are fighting this battle, whether abroad or in India? What is the main thing that we should be trying to help you with? Hame kya karna chahiye aapki madad karne ke liye?
Thank you for that. Thank you for asking. Aap humse baat karte rahiye. Hum apna experience share karenge. Aap apna experience share karenge. Hame bhi bada feel hota hai ki we always love the India. आप हमें बात करते हो, वो एक अच्छी बात है हमारे लिए.
राहुल जी, इन पॉलिसी मेकिंग, आई डोंट थिंक देयर आर द आवर वॉइस इज बीइंग हर्ड इन अ पॉइंट दैट इट शुड बी हर्ड. सो आई थिंक आई वांट टू पुट दैट पॉइंट इन योर माइंड दैट व्हेन अ थिंग कम्स और व्हेन अ पॉलिसी इज बीइंग मेड कंसीडरिंग द नर्सिंग प्रोफेशन और द मेडिकल प्रोफेशन, द एक्सपर्ट्स इन दैट प्रोफेशन शुड बी आस्क्ड फॉर द थिंग. Then only the policy should be made. But unfortunately, that is not being happening in our country. It's very unfortunate to say that, because many organizations or leaders are not being called when it comes to the policy making decisions.
So in all this COVID battle, was there any experience that was positive for you? That you felt
definitely.
This was a very happy
definitely.
Experience? Can you describe?
Definitely, yeah.
Can you describe me one experience like that? What happened, Anu?
I think here in New Zealand, again, the communication between the government and the health workers, it was really, really good. I would say daily at 1 p.m. during that 5 weeks lockdown, our health minister and our president would come and do the press meeting. And I think pretty much all the New Zealanders will tune to hear these numbers, the levels, and the president himself, she made us feel responsible and participating and winning this battle. So the leadership styles were like one of empathy in a crisis.
Yeah, my positive experience I would like to say about, you know, during the weekends, you know, during all this pandemic, COVID cohort unit, developed and working, and the cohort unit I worked at the weekend, none of the nurses had COVID. You know, this was so, a brilliant news for us, you know, because nobody caught. We had 20 patients and, you know, all patients were admitted there were COVID positive patients. None of the nurses had COVID. So
oh, that's good.
That's good news.
So that was such a brilliant news for us.
So my last question. In all this, of course, the non-COVID patients have a completely different trajectory, because the hospital is occupied by COVID patients.
So what, not all of them. Not all of the hospitals we have in our accident and emergency departments. There is a red zone and there is a green zone. So patients were exhibiting the symptoms of COVID. So they were putting into the red zone,
right.
And those other patients who are not coming with the COVID symptoms, so they were going to the green zone.
Right.
So once everybody is getting swabbed, everybody is getting tested. So this is the only way we know. And now we are not seeing many patients.
शायद वो यहाँ significant हो गए जो आपने जो सवाल पूछा था.
हाँ.
वो इंडिया में शायद ज्यादा सिग्निफिकेंट है. सरकारी अस्पताल की ओपीडीज भी रन नहीं कर रहे हैं. वो हमारे पास कोई और रास्ता नहीं है राहुल जी. क्योंकि वो भी एक सवाल है क्योंकि, लेकिन हमें उन लोगों को कैसे मदद किया जाएगा ये सोचने वाली बात है. क्योंकि बहुत सारे लोग हैं, मेरे पास भी बहुत सारा फोन आया था, क्योंकि वो कैंसर पेशेंट्स, बहुत सारे पेशेंट्स वो मदद मांग रहे हैं, लेकिन हम कई चीजों पे कर नहीं पा रहे क्योंकि हॉस्पिटल जैसे आपने बोला है वैसे हमारी पूरा हॉस्पिटल मेजोरिटी ऑफ द बेड्स आर बीइंग एलोकेटेड फॉर कोविड नॉट ओनली इन एम्स इन मेजोरिटी ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट हॉस्पिटल्स
आई थिंक दैट इट्स इंपॉर्टेंट दैट पीपल ऑल्सो हियर डिफरेंट वॉइसेस यू नो
यस दैट्स राइट
सो आई फील दैट्स व्हाई आई एम होल्डिंग दीस कन्वर्सेशंस वेयर whether it is nurses or it's experts in their field or it's manual laborers, whoever. But I feel everybody that makes up India should have a voice, should be heard.
Exactly.
I find you have given quite a good perspective.
Yes, absolutely, Lavji, absolutely.
So I think we work as a team and then win against the corona, COVID-19.
So I'd like to thank all of you very much for your time. I know it's valuable because you're involved in the fight against COVID. So thank you very much and very proud of you, all of you, for the work you're doing. Not only you, but millions of nurses and doctors like you who are from our country are doing an excellent job in India and abroad.
Thank you, Rahul. और इस कन्वर्सेशन किया है बहुत 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 धन्यवाद राहुल जी बहुत
थैंक यू
सो ग्रेटफुल
थैंक यू एंड थैंक यू फॉर एवरीथिंग यू हैव डन फॉर वायनाड टू आई शुड से दैट थैंक यू फॉर एवरीथिंग यू हैव डन फॉर वायनाड
यस
ग्रेट थैंक यू
थैंक यू
एंड फॉर ऑल द इंडियन नर्सेस थैंक यू